When you fly, do you have a preflight checklist? There's a lot of checklists on the web. You can go and download one. HELIGUY's got a really good one. I'll put that link in the description below. When I fly for clients and I've got a lot of people around me, there's one checklist. It's got safety briefings in it. If I fly off the water, there's one checklist. If I'm shooting video, there's another checklist. It all kind of changes. But there's one mandatory list of things that I do whenever I fly my drone. It concentrates on two things, or three actually. Power, drone, and the area around your drone. So today I'm gonna be flying a Mavic and an Inspire. And with the Mavic, the one thing that I first check is I just look at it to make sure that all the screws are in the drone. I make sure that the body has no cracks on it that weren't supposed to be there. Before you put a battery in, you just wanna glance right here to make sure that there's no debris inside of there. Check to see if they're swollen. You could feel if they're swollen. If they're swollen, get rid of them. Now, this battery, you might have already noticed right around here, you see a little bit of a gap. That's something to look for. For some reason, out of all the batteries I have, this one pops out. That's why I put a little X on it. And even though it's already kind of out a little bit, it still has enough power. This thing can take off. But this battery would just pop out while flying. So when you put your battery in, you want to make sure it's in there. There's no gap or anything like that. And then when I put the thing down, when I'm just about to fly, I just do a quick little spin on the rotors, and that's checking for two things. One, to make sure that the rotors have enough clearance so there's no, like, you know, rock or pebble or something like that that I didn't see that they're gonna hit. And also, if there is a screw that fell out, or let's say for instance it was like a rock or a pebble that got stuck in this motor, you'd feel it. It would kind of jam a little bit. And I've actually had that. I've had a little tiny sliver of metal get stuck in one of the magnets inside a motor on an older Phantom, and luckily I discovered it and pulled it out. The last thing I do is I just kind of feel the propellers. I don't bend them, but I just put a little bit of pressure on them to make sure that there's no cracks or little holes or anything like that. This particular propeller has to be changed because it does have, I don't know if this is like a stress fracture or, and this is pretty much what you're looking for, a little tiny crack like this. This was originally on the rear, and I won't use that anymore. So this is why it's always good to have spares with you. All right, now when it comes to setting up the Inspire, there's only one or two extra steps I'll do. Now with the Inspire, because I'm clicking these things on, I really make sure that they're clicked on. When I put the batteries on, I literally try to push them back. Even though it's clicked and the button's up, I don't want these things to fall off. So I make sure I'm really pushing those things. And then with the gimbal, because I'm attaching that, one, I make sure the gimbal's clicked on and I try to actually turn it. I make sure the lens is fastened on. I make sure the lens hood is nice and tight. If you've got extra lenses for this thing and you've got those lens weights that may help it stay balanced on the gimbal, you wanna make sure the lens weight is extra tight, just because you just don't want them falling off while you're flying. So as far as other checklist items that I have, check out the area. 2 seconds ago, there was a ton of seagulls around here. Once I started this thing up and flew it around a little bit, they flew away. But you wanna look around for birds. You wanna make sure it's clear above your drone. Right now, it's tempting for me to wanna fly out from underneath these trees because I'm in the shade and I don't wanna move, and then fly out and do my little thing. But let's say, for instance, for any situation, return to home was kicked in. I don't want that drone coming back down and landing in all these branches up here. So make sure that you've got, like, where you're taking off, like a 10-foot circle, because GPS isn't always 100% accurate, and your drone's gonna come back not exactly at the same point where you took off from. So give it plenty of room. Oh, also, when going back to return to home, make sure your return to home settings are what you want them to be. So I'm on land flying out over water, so I want return to home to take the drone back. It's windy, so I might want to set the return to home a little lower if I'm flying over water, but if I'm flying over high trees, I might want to reset the return to home settings so it has enough clearance to get over those trees. If I'm on a boat out in the water, I'll probably want to have my return to home setting set to hover. This way, if the boat loses, or if I lose connection while I'm on a boat, it's not gonna return to a point where I'm no longer there and then land in the water. So I hope that helped. I'm trying to keep the wind at my back so you don't hear that wind noise. The other thing is, you don't wanna take off or land in sport mode. I mean, you can do it, but the controls are a little jerkier, the drone's got a little more power to it, and the front obstacle sensors are turned off. All right, so the first thing I do is I pretty much just put it up in the air so I can just listen to it. I'll do a quick little rotation, and then once it has GPS, I just pretty much take my fingers off the controls, and I just make sure that the drone can hover by itself and I don't have to assist it. And like, for instance, maintaining it's pretty windy and it's actually maintaining its position and its height. That means everything's pretty much checked out. And if one of the propellers wasn't put on correctly, it would have flown off by now.
First off, sorry about the wind noise. There's really nothing I could do about that other than shoot it over, but I don't have time to do that. And I figure progress is better than perfection, so we'll move on. Also, did you see the guy that was behind me with the feeding the birds? All right, I find these locations where there's no one around, so I don't have anyone bothering me. I don't have anyone coming up to me and say, what are you filming? Anyway, long story short, I actually had to stop. I got swarmed by so many seagulls because once the seagulls saw him, they came over to me. They're like, hey, this guy's probably got food too. And the guy's feeding them dog food. Lastly, you might have seen me looking at my phone a couple times during the video. And the reason why is because I actually keep my checklist on my reminders app. The reason I like putting it on reminders as opposed to having it printed out is because if something changes in my workflow, I could change it immediately on my list. If a DP tells me, hey, remember to have these settings and or XYZ or meet me at this spot, I can just put it on this list. And it's live everywhere, laptop, home computer, this thing. Anyway, I hope you got something out of that. Let me know what some of your thoughts are below. My name is John O'Sullivan from O'Sullivan Studios. Thanks for watching.